Hey, Rick here. Well, we got a little bit of sun this morning. It's October 13th, and we went from 90 degree weather down to this 40, 50 degree weather, so overnight. Didn't even get a chance to be able to open the windows up for a few days or anything, so went right from air conditioning to cooling. So, anyway, hey, I'm going to show you the problems I'm having with my late 90s E150 Ford van. I know everybody has problems with these rear door latches on this thing, and it's been really frustrating the last 6 months. I keep, you know, doctoring it around, doing a little fix here, a little fix there. And finally, it's just gotten to the point where the whole mechanism fell apart, and then I was trying to put that back together, and then the cable in broke off, and there's two cables up on this thing. And so Wednesday, let me start back a little further than that. Last weekend, I ordered the parts to replace all the parts on the back of this van. Cost me about, $90-some. It got it all from Rock Auto. I like Rock Auto. So they bring that stuff right to you, to your door, and it's pretty cheap and good parts. Haven't had any trouble anyway with other parts I've bought from them. So, this is not a commercial for Rock Auto. I'm just telling you that's where I bought it. Long story short, last Wednesday it was pouring down rain. It was starting to get cool, and, can't get in the back door. So, Thaddeus was helping me that day, and we got the tarp out and got back in the back. He crawled through the back, which I'm going to show you what you have to do to get into this thing, because we're going to try to fix it today. So he crawls through the back. I get outside, and we take the license plate bracket all out, and we're working and the speakers out, and we get our hands up in there, and we finally get the door open. And I'm trying to get some sort of a cable pieced together so that we can get this door open and shut, because I don't have the parts yet, and you know I have to be able to get in this thing. So anyway, we get that tarp up, and it's pouring down rain, and just as I get my face down in under there to look under what's going on inside that door, the rain, there's a hole in the tarp, and it's running down on my glasses, and I can't see, and it was just awful. So anyway, we finally got the door put together. I'm going to show you when we go back here how to get the door open right now. But the parts are all in. They came in. The rest of the parts came in last night or yesterday evening, probably when I got home, they were on the porch. So I'm going to show you how I'm going to fix this thing. I've looked at several videos on YouTube, and there was actually a home inspector guy over in Illinois, I think he was, who's been having the same problem, and he really had a good video on the breakdown of how this door is put together. I mean, Ford, they must pay these guys to sit up there with their AutoCAD and design crap that is never going to work or never hold up, because it is a crazy design. So anyway, we're going to climb through here, and we're going to get these doors open, and I'll try to take some video and show you what I'm doing. So, all right, let's get this thing opened up. Of course, this is how you have to do it, because you can't open it from the outside, so you have to crawl through all this junk that's in this van. Heaven forbid that you really got it full of stuff. When we're hauling things in here and it won't open, it's really hard to get back in here. So what I did, and I've got the cover off here, as you can see, it's supposed to have a cover like this. I just left that off. It's over at the shop, and I'll put it back on later. But what we did was I took a piece of cable and I ran it through this hole here. So now if you just pull on this, it will unlatch the door. But as you can see, that's unhandy. So we're not going to do it that way. So we're going to take all this out. I'll try to set the camera up.
where you can see it, and
we'll get our tools out here. And again, that's where I bought my parts from. So anyway, yeah, there's a picture of my grandpa. He's always on my toolbox. So anyway, okay, I'll show you more in a minute. These things come apart really easy because I've had this apart so many times in the last 6 months that it's a wonder the screws even hold. You've got to take this license plate assembly completely out. You can't just buy the door latch, because I was having two problems. One is the door latch itself that's mounted to this license plate bracket, and the other is the cables, but the cables didn't give way until just recently. But I'll show you more when we get this taken all apart. You know, it's just made out of plastic and pop metal. I mean, you know, it's just not worth it. It's not worth the products it's made with. Okay, so here's what we got going on. I'll lay this down here and show you a little bit. Originally, what was happening was this screw would, from the vibration of the road, would back out, and then it would allow this little lever to ride up on top of the latch. So you would pull the latch, and that little thing would pop up on the top, and then you couldn't get in the vehicle. You had to crawl through, take the door apart from the inside, and then you could get it apart, put this all back together. So I tried some Loctite on this screw. That didn't work. It still vibrated loose. I guess I didn't get it clean enough. So finally, I drilled a hole right here in my door so that I could run a screwdriver through there once a week and tighten that screw up. Otherwise, just crazy stuff. I mean, anyway, bad design. Shame on Ford. So anyway, after I messed with this for about 6 months, trying to just find this part instead of buying this whole assembly, then these cables broke. That's one of the, this is the new cable here. But there's actually a cable. There's two cables that runs from this door latch. One is up at the top and runs down, and one comes down this way for this handle. So finally, this one broke, so you couldn't even get into it from crawling through from the inside. So I bought all the parts, and we're going to try to put it together. So, show you more. Put some gloves on here because the metal on this truck is sharp. Cut my hands all up.
still a thousand miles away. Step into my heart.
Sing it, Dean. Now, to get this door latch out of here, this rivet holds in the automatic door lock assembly, and so you can't just take that out. Of course, you know, we wouldn't want that to fall out. Instead of putting a rivet on this piece over here, we put a rivet on here, so you can't take this assembly out without drilling that rivet out. But I've been told by watching some of the videos on YouTube that you can manipulate it around once you get it unhooked enough to get that down out of there, because you can't put the cables on it unless you get the assembly down out of there. So that's what we're going to try to do here. Here's what we're looking at. I don't know if you can see that with the camera or not, if it will focus on that. See that little piece right there? That is the end of the cable. And that has to pull that lever over to unlatch that. And then there's another one that comes up from down here in the bottom. So anyway, I'm gonna see if I can get that out of there. Okay, it's been about 15 minutes, and I finally got the automatic door lock system out. This has little grommets that fit into this, so you don't have to take that, you don't have to drill that rivet out. I didn't know that, and no place online, any of the TO books online or anything like that does it say you can do that, but that's what I found you can do. And so I had to take the rod. This is where the little door lock button's at. So this is up in here like this. So I took that out. That enabled me to slip this down, and then I could see that this was pivoting on here, and so I was able to pop that out. So now this thing actually sets up in here like this. Okay. So now what I've got to do. Actually, that's not right. It sets up in here like this. So now what I've got to do is I've got to thread through the cable on this one and the short cable on here. And I was told by one of the guys online, because I don't know which cable goes where, but one of the guys I was watching online said the short cable goes on here because it goes down to the door latch there. And then the long cable comes up out of here and circles down and then hooks to this piece. So anyway, we're gonna see if I can get the cables on there, and then we'll see if we can get this back in there. All right. Okay, so I got the cables in. As you can see, they fit in those little clips. And if I'm going by what this guy online said, that this short one goes there and the long one goes on the top. So we'll see if that's the case, because this one will have to turn and hook into that latch, and then this long one will turn and come down to the latch that is mounted on this license plate light. So, all right, so let's see if we can get it back in there. Okay, I got that up in there finally. You can see I had to take this rubber stuff that was all kind of stretched out and worn out for the last 20 years. I had to cut that off to get the clips to go in there. So now the door lock works. One way I check it before I actually put it back together, and I don't have all the screws in this, you can see, but we're going to trip this mechanism. And then we can pull this lever. I've got this one hooked up, and it releases it. So we'll latch it back. And then this one here, the one that hooks to this license plate bracket mechanism, that's this cable right here. So if I pull this, it should pop this open. It's going to be hard to do.
holding the camera as well, but there, we released it. So now we'll get this all put back together and we'll give it a shot and see if it works. I don't even add a key to this lock, but you've got to have it on there because the door latch, the automatic door lock system won't even latch if this is not in there. So I'm going to put it back in there. But I don't know. I got this band second or third hand kind of thing, and the keys I've got for it do not operate this. So anyway, there's that. Mechanism's a little different now. I noticed that it's actually reinforced. You look at the differences here, and it may be an aftermarket product. I don't know. I mean, obviously. Whoever designed this star stuff, this is ridiculous. I mean, why did you try to improve upon a Phillips? You know, the automotive industry has went from straight blade to clutch head, which most of you probably don't even know what that is. I've got a clutch head screwdriver right here for the old Chevrolet and Ford. And I'm talking about long before my time, but I've worked on a lot of them. And you know what? I know I've got one of those clutch heads here. I'm just going to show you. driver works much better than this. Or just put a nut on the end of it. You know, what's wrong with a nut? Now, this is a Reed and Prince. If you look at this, it looks like a Phillips screwdriver to the first glance, but it has a flat end on it, and there's different sizes of these. And then there's this little thing. I forget what this particular screwdriver is called. Maybe you guys can help me out, but it just has two little dots, and you stick it in there, and you back them out. So anyway, a Reed and Prince actually looks like a little figure eight instead of a like four slots here. It looks like a little figure eight, and it insets down into the screws. Dodge and I said Ford a while ago, but it was Dodge, Chrysler, and Chevrolet in the older days there for a while. I know I had a 37 Chevy pickup that had those clutch heads on it. So. Anyway, not important. But the reason I was complaining is that you have to use this little bitty clutch head or little bitty torques on these great big screws, and to put this license bracket in, and it's just like, you know, it just doesn't work very good, guys. Again, you know, we've got some college guy that sits in front of a CAD computer and comes up with all these formulas, probably doesn't even know how to turn a wrench, and thinks he's got a new concept. You know, on fixing a problem that didn't need to be fixed. So, anyway, just make it simple, guys. Build it out of good stuff. So we don't have to keep buying stuff all the time. Yeah. I'm just not a person that goes out and buys a new vehicle all the time, so. At least not anymore. And if you only would be long for the rest of my days, I will whisper the scream. I've got the sense of all. She's been long up here. Mimi's been long. And all those lambs out here, it's gone. In fact, you'd be surprised on this around here, Frank. Alright, now let's see if this thing works. Okay, so if we trip this, sure it's unlocked. It is. Aha! Yeah. And we'll pull this handle. Look at that. I think it's gonna work, guys. Okay. I'm gonna get it put back together. Get this van cleaned out now that I can get in it. It's a mess. So, thanks for watching. Bye. Run, Tallulah, run!
Hi, baby.